Hello everyone, welcome to Speedway Motors Tech Talk. My name is Joe and we're here with our 68C10 project and we are about to install our 67 to 72 fabricated transmission mount and LS swap motor mount kit. And this is a new product, we're really excited about it. There's lots of cool features built into both of these, lots of adjustability in this transmission cross member. The motor mounts are designed to use a stock LS F-body motor mount. So some really neat details that we'll talk through as we install them here. All right, we're gonna start by installing these motor mount brackets. And a neat thing about both the motor mounts and the transmission crossmember is that there's no fabrication required. There's no cutting, there's no welding, and you don't even have to drill any holes because they're engineered to go in holes that are already in these chassis and crossmembers. And these holes are slotted, so it gives you a little bit of latitude forward and back. And that's even more so the case on the transmission crossmember, which we'll get to in a minute. But we will install this using the provided hardware. They come with these locking nuts to make sure they're not going anywhere. And we're gonna just start by finger tightening everything until we actually get our engine and transmission in here. All right, with these motor mount brackets installed, you can see a couple things. First, you can kind of see how they're designed to interface with the 98-02 F-body motor mount. And you can also see with the slotted holes, just how much latitude you have to go forward and back on these. So these are designed to work in these trucks, but you have a little bit of fine tuning that you can do through the slotted holes. So with these loosely installed, we're gonna move on to the transmission crossmember. Like the motor mounts, the transmission crossmember utilizes holes that are already in your frame and has just a ton of adjustability in it. And it's also worth noting, we're gonna start with these boxing plates first, that these holes are offset, which allows you to flip them to raise or lower the transmission crossmember. So we'll start by installing this in the lowest setting and kind of see how things look. Not only do you have a ton of existing holes here in the frame, but the holes in these boxing plates are also slotted. So once you've picked which hole your bolt's gonna go in, you still have a ton of forward and back adjustability. So these should accommodate just about any transmission you can dream up. And also like the motor mounts, we're going to just finger tighten these to allow us to adjust them as we install things. Next, we're gonna install the crossmember itself. Now, if you just want this transmission crossmember separately, if you're running a different engine or you already have your motor mount set up, this transmission crossmember is available as its own part, separately from the motor mount kit. And you notice there's just a ton of room here for exhaust to pass through. This was designed to get a 3-inch exhaust through and still have a ton of ground clearance. So we'll get this installed and then we'll install our mock-up engine and transmission. All right, everything is installed now, kind of finger tight. We're gonna install a mock-up engine and transmission, and then we'll tighten things down. All right, since we're just mocking things up, we have this gutted Turbo 400 that we're gonna put in here. It's time to install the motor mounts. We're using our steel LS mock-up block here. It's worth paying attention to, these motor mounts have these little tabs. That is the top. And you'll notice on the mount adapters on the frame that there's a little notch there for those tabs to go into. All right, we're ready to bolt our transmission up to our block here. And this is cool, with all of the adjustability that's in this crossmember, you can just slide the transmission right up to the mock-up block. All right, we've got all of our mock-up stuff kind of bolted in here. This is going to give us a chance to test fit some pieces, kind of fine tune the positioning in the chassis before we snug these mounts down. This transmission crossmember, it's worth noting, we just happen to have a Turbo 400 in here. This will work with just about any transmission you can dream up. There's enough holes in the chassis, there's enough slots in the brackets that you can move it forward and back just about anywhere you need to. As far as our mount kit goes, we're about done with the installation here. If you have any questions about any of this, feel free to give us a call, and thanks for watching.